Hi, I'm Edwin Tiong. I'm the voice actor for Yasaurus, one of Edge of Eternity's main characters, and I will be your host for this commentated gameplay. First things first, let's start this walkthrough by changing the party leader. I feel we should have someone with, more class, more presence, more charisma. Someone like... There. Exactly who I had in mind. Now we can get this thing started. So, this walkthrough takes place at roughly the middle of the game, in the Elysian Fields, where the party hopes to recruit their next member. Nothing like a small cutscene to set the mood. Seems like a good time to remind everyone that in addition to the already stellar English voice acting, the game will also feature Japanese voice acting on console release, and will be available as a free update for PC as well. At any time, you will be able to choose between the Japanese and the English version. Not that I'm biased towards one or the other, of course, totally impartial.
送信機を探すんだよ。何のために連れてきたと思ってる。ひょっとして送信機がどんなのかわからないのか。アークリットが遠いところから連絡を取り合うのに使う装置だろ。お前アークリットの技術に詳しかったのか。まず敵を知れっていうしな。そういやお前兵士だったな。誰に連絡を取るの。アバリスに送ってくれる飛行船の船長だ。
バロン、自称空賊だ。どういうことかは俺にもわからないが、俺たちサイファーはアークリットの技術を盗んでほしいときいつもあいつに頼んでた。当然大金を払ってな。じゃあ俺たちも払わないといけないのか。ああ、腕と足は犠牲になるな。<笑>
Now that one's a joke because, So the transmitter is on the other side of these fields. You would have known that if you actually paid attention to the cutscene instead of listening to what I was saying. Maybe we should get ourselves a Nekaru in order to get there faster. Good girl. Nekarus are one of the main means of transportation in Herion. You'll get one during the game's second chapter. They're cute, I know. But being unbearably cute is not this critter's only perk, you'll see. There, our oversized catmount has picked up a scent. If we follow the directions shown by this reticle, our Nekaru will eventually find some kind of buried treasure. Or some other nasty surprise. Like this borrower. Nyek. I suggest we end this pathetic worm's life before its fluids ruin our valiant hero's clothes. As you can see on the screen, the game uses an active time battle system to decide the turn's order. When it comes to your turn, you will choose between several skills, attacks, and items at your disposal to triumph over your enemies. You can also move your characters on the Nexus grid, useful to set up sneak attacks. Now let's pick a few bombastic abilities to quickly bring this combat to an end. And boom, voila. I admit, this foe was barely worth our time. Maybe we should pick a fight with a more imposing foe. Like a stalker, for instance. Now where can we find one? Ah, talking to NPCs. A staple in RPGs. What? No side quests? No loot? Just flavor text? Come on, don't make us believe that's an actual lore in this game. Okay, we get it. Ooh, shinies. A crystal, huh? This thing would fit right onto Selene's staff. Let's open up the menu and see our customization options. Ooh, theory crafting in sight. Let's put our newly found crystal in a slot right there. Now the Fire Rift 2 spell will be available in combat. Neato. Ah, there's a stalker. Scary. For difficult combat such as these, character placement is important, as it can both allow your characters to evade some of the enemy's most dangerous attacks, as well as set up devastating sneak attacks. On top of the Fire Rift crystal we have slotted earlier, we have also assigned lightning attack crystals into our weapons, which will allow us to strike this enemy's elemental weakness. See those red figures? It means the attack has been extra painful, probably because we struck the enemy from behind. Hey, don't judge me. It's a tactical RPG. I have every right to do this. Let's assert dominance by taking a nap right in the middle of the fight. Power move right there. Now the only thing left to do is to leave the other teammates at it while our lovable rascal continues sleeping and replenishing his HP. Come on guys, make yourselves useful. Do something, I don't know, a special attack maybe? Yeah. positively radical. And this concludes the fight. Easy peasy. Our quest objective is getting close. Ah, this could very well be the transmitter we're looking for. See? I was right.
Shuhasu, yoshi. Midori no light wa hikatteru. Switch mo ireta shi, kore de ugoku daro. Faron, kikoeru ka? Faron, kikoeru ka?
聞こえてるはずだ。ファロン、返金してくれ。前回の分が機能しない。返金しないならもうお前に金は。あんたが返金してもらえるとでも？聞こえてるじゃないか。ああ、聞こえてるよ。警備システムにもね。ったく、迷惑なこった。ファロン、アーバリスに行きたいんだ。俺の連れはお前に全財産はたこうとしてるぜ。
おい、代金も聞いてないのに。無理だね。こっちはヴァンガードに閉じ込められてるんだ。ヴァンガ、アークリットの巡洋艦か？いくらぶっ飛んでるお前でもあそこに行くのは自殺行為だよ。手に負えないことをやろうとしてるのさ。だから今回は力になれない。アバリスには別の方法で行くんだね。おっと、切らないと。
追ってが来る。くそ、閉まらない最後だね。ヴァンガード魔境だ。誰も生きては帰れない。ファロンは突っ込んだけどな。今から向かったところでもう死んでるだろう。飛行船はやめて水上戦にするか。
それじゃあお友達は？友達ではないな。ちょっと前に命を助けられはしたが、それに自分の意思で突っ込んだんだ。命かけてまで助けたくはねえよ。俺も賛成だ。もう寄り道してる暇はない。どうにか封鎖を突破しないと。私は反対よ。
お兄ちゃん、封鎖を突破するのは危険だって自分で言ったんじゃない。それにあなたも、あの女の人に借りがあるんでしょ。それはもう返し。見捨てちゃダメ。2対1だ。彼女のことは自分でどうにかしてもらおう。そう。じゃあ2人で封鎖を突破してアバリスまで泳いで行って、私が1人で助けに行くから。
So much for collegial decision taking.
アバリスの騎士で待ってるわ。泳いでくる二人に手を振ってあげる。ああ、またか。で、これ追うのか。仕方ないだろう。いつもこんな感じか。こんな感じだな。
Back on the field, the dreaded vanguard shouldn't be too far. almost there. And there. A little something extra for our most beloved character. Well-deserved, I'd say. Oh, and by the way, if you're not too fond of digging the dirt to get new weapons, you can craft them. The game includes more than 100 weapons, all with their own specific customizable crystal tree.
ついたぞ。ヴァンガードだ。
大丈夫? 傷のせい? 痛むの?
ちょっと待ってくれ。 もう大丈夫。 ちょっとめまいがしただけだ。 時間がない。 行くぞ。
So, this wraps up our little walkthrough. I hope you enjoyed it. On behalf of the whole Midgar Studios team and myself, thank you for your interest in Edge of Eternity. The game will be released on Xbox One and Series on February 10th. Thanks for watching. See you soon in Herion.